Welcome to Living on the Ocean, using carbon to make it strong enough. The transom from Trimaran Dawn that we extended on the sandbank is only made from foam and glass fiber, and there will be thousands of kilos from the backstay and the rudder coming on it. This is the carbon housing that we already made for the rudder, and on the top are the pipes which will work as the hinge. In the last episode we were busy making a bulkhead towards which the hinge in the new transom is going to be connected, but for that we need to know the angle that the rudder blade is going to be in the water so we can set this pipe in the new transom in the correct angle. With a marker I'm continuing the line of the hinge over the rudder blade, and I come to the conclusion that there is 2 cm per meter difference between the axle and the end of the rudder, plus the 1 cm because we're gonna tip the whole boat backwards is 3 cm. I now know how to glue the pipe in that direction. Job done, we know one of the angles, but we're for sure not yet ready to glue it all together. We need to find out what the exact middle is in the boat and how far we also heeling to port or to starboard. And all that measuring takes forever. It's basically a line from the mast towards the end of the boat. But then we do assume that the mast is standing in the middle. We could start measuring the sides, but then we assume that the sides are straight. And I've been in too many boats to know that there can be a lot more wrong than you would expect. So measure and remeasure and find out where the mistakes are so you can work. And when I've also made a correction for port and starboard, I glue it all together. Having taken serious time to put paper around the stainless steel tube to make sure it doesn't get stuck in the carbon pipe for the rudder hinge. So, the next day, I can take the pipe out. I had taped it well to make sure that I wasn't gonna glue it permanently in that position or breaking my pipe out of place. So we can take our bulkhead out now. That's not stuck either, so we did well with the glue. So there's the pipe stuck to the bulkhead with the fillets on the side. That worked out very nicely. Now we have a job to put carbon fiber around this pipe and over this board in this direction. So it's really gonna hang with a lot of force on that board. But that board is not strong enough to do that. So what we need to do first is making this bulkhead a lot stronger with putting carbon fiber in 45 degrees over this board. All the pieces of carbon fiber. First all in one direction and then all in the other direction. And that on both sides. So it's gonna be 4 layers, 2 on each side. And then I realized I didn't have my film camera on. So I just laminated everything, covered it with glass and waited for this to cure, to be nicely cut and sanded into shape. And then I also sanded in the extension the sides all the way from port down to starboard down.
Okay, this is the position where the backstay is gonna pull on my boat. And it's gonna run in a forwards angle. This angle is 9 meters forwards and 80 meters up. That's 1 till 2, that's easy. So the fibers need to be in the same direction. Strips of unidirectional fibers, they will be rolled in here and laminated down. I can do the calculation with you again, but every strip of this is 7,000 kilos breaking strength. There are gonna be 6 there, that's more than 40,000 kilos. I'm gonna go 20 centimeter wide and my fibers go all the way down here. And when they come to the bottom here, they will actually cross over that. And that also means it straight away will make a very strong connection for putting this bulkhead that's gonna handle the rudder. That means the forces that come on there are carried with the same carbon fiber that I already put there. And obviously it's smarter to do that first than stop all my carbon fiber right there where the strain of the board is. I'd rather have those fibers go underneath on both sides and then put the bulkhead on top of it.
And again the roll, let's cut all the pieces into shape. A bit longer than before. Starts to look very nice, the black carbon. And there they are, all in place.
Okay, now I'm gonna put a layer of filler. Actually, not a layer, just gonna close the deep gaps, because they just become air voids. On here.
Making sure I fill this all up very, very well and scrape it away afterwards, so there's nothing actually left on the top of it, just only the holes are very well closed.
Problem is, it's so hot already that I'm sweating, so I have to be very careful not to drip on here, because every drip is not going to help what I'm doing. So, I can take my first. I don't need this measurement. I'm going to lay them out here. I think that's just out of your sight. Problem now is, what was the first? See how short this is? I can say that's the wrong one. So this must be this one. That looks better. So that's my first fiber. Get the water off my face, get my roller, and put enough resin on there. It's basically the same job as doing glass fiber. It's just a much stronger fiber, carbon, with a very little stretch, what brings less forces on the resin. But you have to take in account that this fiber will break before the carbon, before the glass fiber underneath will actually start taking any loads. And that's sometimes a mistake. People add them towards each other. You cannot do it if they have a different stretch. So that's one. All I want is those forces to go nicely from here, that's just above your head, and then down all the way to here. So let them soak for a while and then roll over it one more time is the way I do it. But that's two. It's warm, so we're gonna speed it up a little bit, because else my epoxy will go off. Now, how much epoxy do you need? Glass fiber is basically the same amount of weight as the fibers, the same amount of weight as the glass. With carbon, that's a 40 to 60. In volume, 60% carbon, because it's lighter, and 40% resin.
But in weight, that actually means you need to take a little bit more than 50% resin.
So I just need to get some sweat off my face. And that's why I'm always very happy I put gloves over this, because I took the other ones off. So I put some new ones on. And we're gonna start the other side. That means I first gonna wet it again. And there went my roller off my... If your roller comes off, it's not such a problem, but don't roll backwards, roll forwards, and it stays on. Now, I'm not an engineer. And I may make mistakes, and I've been doing it then for 30 years. I've not seen problems on the ocean. My boats hold together. But some of you may be able to tell me something that will improve my work. And I'd be very happy to hear that. Now, obviously the nice thing again would be peel ply over this, because you don't want to send carbon. So what I'm going to do is going to lay one layer of glass over it and then plaster it smooth. And then I will sand it and just touch the carbon where I'm going to make connections, or actually just not touch the carbon, but get in that in-between sweet spot. Nice thing from carbon fiber. You need less material of it to make it as strong as the glass. That means you need less epoxy, but then also it holds in fatigue 80% of its original strength. Glass fiber drops down till about 40. If you take fatigue with you in the calculations of this material, you can work with a lot less. And if you don't think carbon can bend, then look at the wings of airplanes. I used to make carbon fiber fins for diving, for free diving, and they can bend double. I still have some, I may show you once. Infusing up to only a mil of carbon on the end was quite a trick to get the epoxy thin enough to do that. And we're still considering starting to do that again, and it will be really fun to do it for this channel, to show you how you can make a shape, fill it with carbon, the perfect amount, and then infuse it. For now, as simple as possible. A, it works for me, and B, I like it if you guys can copy some of it for your own benefits. I think we have a visitor. It's Rory. Rory wants to be on the video. And I also have the rudder hinge standing on here.
Oh, okay.
So yeah. I want that. I thought I'd do it all in one go.
Yeah.
So that's the last one. You will hear in the background, obviously when you're busy, there's people coming and visiting, which is nice, but not possible to stop in the middle of a laminating job with carbon fiber. Sometimes people think you can easily take a 5-minute break, but no, they're my epoxy cures, so I cannot. Well, that's a very strong reinforcement in the boat. Now we're going to put some glass over there.
Now this glass is basically sacrificial. I do not want to send the carbons later, as I already explained. So before this glass is very well cured, I'm going to put a layer of filler plaster over this, filling all the voids and the holes. The chain plate itself that I'm going to build with carbon is going to be connected on here. It needs to be done very well. So I'm going to be grinding this again to get very good connection. We'll grind it till I can just see that I'm going to the glass, which is, yeah, something that works very well for me, because you get that black all of a sudden show up, or actually you can see it coming. And that makes sure that I don't destroy all those fibers that are laying here, because those fibers go a tiny bit up and down and they're laying a bit over bumps. If you just cut those all through, you're basically destroying your work. Peel ply is a nylon cloth which you could lay over here. And because it's nylon, you can pull it back off. But even then, there's an argument going on, maybe depending upon the kind of peel ply or whatever. But there's an advice to still sand it after you pull the peel ply off to make a good connection. One thing I know for sure, if I do it this way, I get a very rough and good connection that has been always working for me. And if you don't have peel ply, this works. On the middle of the ocean, you may not have peel ply. Finishing it with a white layer of filler makes a very interesting result. And the reinforced bulkhead for the rudder hinge still fits very nicely. It almost can be glued permanently in here. It's a very strong board with the fibers that we put on it in plus and minus 45 degree angles. Like that and like that. The carbon fiber pipe that's in that opening there needs to be reinforced with lots of strips of carbon. It looks nice already. It's black, but there's actually no fibers yet going around this pipe and being glued away over this board, which will then lead the forces away in this board that we now made very strong. The fibers need to come from this side, around this pipe, and then go towards the other side in a horizontal line over the plus minus 45 degree pieces of fiber we already put on this very strong board. And in the next episode, I almost messed it all up while I'm putting the layers of fiber on this pipe to make it very, very strong. And I will leave the mistake in so you can see it. It's a good lesson to be learned, and lucky enough, I managed to save it. And why am I making this so very strong? Above here is a link when I crossed my new Trimaran Twilight across the Atlantic and the bottom rudder hinge broke. When I was in the water, Portuguese man of war landed on my knee and I could only just climb back on board from the pain and had to press the SOS, and a rescue helicopter wanted to come and rescue me. I know the bottom hinge gets a lot of forces and I'm gonna make it strong enough. We hope you enjoyed this episode of Living on the Ocean, and we really thank you for all your likes and comments. We always look forward towards your comments and we do our best to answer them. Sometimes they get a bit lost, but give us a bit of time to find them, because we sincerely want to stay in contact with you and answer your questions. Thank you for watching, and I hope you subscribe to our channel to follow our adventures. See you next time.